This short tutorial will show you how to search for classes in MyGCC. Begin by logging into your MyGCC account. Then select Course Search from the menu on the left. You can fill in as much or as little of the search options as you want. The more you fill in, the fewer results you will get. Let's go through some of the criteria. Make sure to select the term you are actually trying to register for. You can choose a specific subject by scrolling through this alphabetical list. The course code is the three-digit number that comes after the subject. For example, in English 101, 101 would be the course code. Instead of entering a specific subject or course code, you can also enter a word or a few words that describe your interests so that you can see all courses that address that topic. The search criteria gets more specific as you move down the page. Check off this box if you only want your search results to show classes that still have available seats. If you want to see all classes, including those that are full and might require you to go on a wait list, leave this box unchecked. The course type option allows you to narrow your search by session. Flex Start will show you the courses that run outside of the traditional semester start and end date. For example, with that option, you might find classes that start a couple weeks or maybe even halfway through the semester instead of running for the whole term. January Intersession is a way to search for just classes that are offered over winter break. You can leave both of these blank to see all of the courses for the term that you're searching for. Instructional method indicates how the course will be delivered. Face-to-face is your traditional in-person classes. Hybrid is a mix of in-person and online. Online with no set meetings means the course is fully online and does not require you to be logged in at any specific time or on any specific days. An online with set virtual meetings means the course is delivered online, but that you do need to be logged in on the days and at the times listed in the search results. Other information you can enter include credit range. For example, you might be specifically searching for a one-credit course or a three-credit course. You can search by instructor. You can select the specific days and even a range of times when you want the courses you're looking for to meet. Again, the more information that you fill in on this search criteria page, the fewer results you will get when you search for the classes. When you have finished entering all the search criteria you plan to use, click Class Search. The search results will display all the classes that match the criteria you entered. For each result, you will see a course description, including any prerequisites. A prerequisite is another class you need to take or a requirement you need to meet in order to enroll in the class that you are looking at. You will also see the days and times the class meets, if there are required meeting times. The location information tells you a couple of things. If it is an in-person class, the location tells you the building and the room where the class will meet. If it's an online class, the location will say remote if the course is one that has set virtual meeting times, or online if the course is one with no set meeting times. The date range tells you when the class begins and ends. This is a good way to double check whether you're looking at a regular class or a flex start class. Regular classes will run for the whole semester from beginning to end, whereas flex start classes will have shorter date ranges. The instructor of the class will also be listed. You might see GCC staff here if an instructor has not yet been assigned. You can keep checking back to look for a specific name. Above the information we've just discussed are a couple of helpful links. You can click View Course Materials to be linked to our college bookstore, where you can see any textbooks, supplies, or other materials that will be required for the class. And you can click View Seat Availability to see the capacity of the class, how many students are already enrolled in the class, and how many seats are left. Hopefully, these quick tips will help you get started searching for classes in MyGCC. Reach out to the Academic Advising Center if you need help with this or any other part of the registration process. We're here to help.